Kubor nagashlem jong unong san hima.
Usembut menteri rang ba kajelau ba prestun tensong hani kesengi kan riuterik unai wing ula kentaj war ba kadon kejingke itu ya udawyong. Raina keliang gujung u ula kubur ba kadon kejingkit ya udawyong. Bat uni udawyong uba kikit udai uba kihab ban lilam. Su-su ula kendu dag ba ong balada pikwa ban lap ya gejing sisya lecaki officer kibapet pin lap ya gejing sisya baro.
You need to understand one thing. The unclaimed gold means seized by the state authority. Then we send this to the court. The court will decide. After we get the order from the court that you have to dispose it of or auction it, so we did it. As far as those old stock gold conducted by the NGT, then ultimately it went to the Supreme Court. And then ultimately the Supreme Court accepted the report of the NGT. And the Supreme Court says this 32 lakhs metric ton of coal has to be auctioned. But the criteria is late. The criteria is auction of the old stock has to be done by Coal India, and the working plan has to be prepared by the Coal India jointly with the state government, and then that working plan has to be submitted to the NGT, and NGT has to approve it. Series of meetings were held. It doesn't mean that we did not. Series of meetings were held, and I'm just telling you in short. Now we are in the final stage. Now we are in the final stage because, as I said to you, working policy has to be done, presented by Coal India and the state government, and then it has to be approved by the NGT as per the Supreme Court ruling. So it takes time because of that. Otherwise, from the state government, in fact, that time itself. After we received the ruling from this board, we wanted to dispose of next days. We wanted to auction it next days. But as I said, there are so many criteria laid down where we need to ultimately meet that criteria, the laid down criteria. And then hopefully within no time from now, NGT will approve it and then we will be able to auction it. No, the illegality. I'm talking about illegality. About illegality, we don't know the evidence. Why do we need evidence for the illegality? The illegality, the allegation. I'm talking about the allegation. Because see, be it opposition, be it somebody they allege, they come out in the press statement that, oh, this so and so is like that, oh, this is like that, oh, government is like that, oh, it's like that. I mean, so many allegations were made. Why I said, when you have that allegation, you need to stop substantiate it. Who said that? Oh, great. So let him place it on the table of the house. Let him place it on the table of the house. If he has got that evidence, let Dr. Mukul put a detailed presentation in the house. Now we are in session. From Monday till Thursday, you go and tell him. Oh, if they have 9 points, means the government of Meghala, they take so stringent policy in place where they have 9 or 10 checkpoints, is it not? Because it's not so easy to pass from one point to another point. Okay. See, if you saying that transportation of coal is still going on, I said yes. Transportation of coal is still on. And that coal, where the transportation is taking place even till this moment, it is the coal where the court has said auction it. You get away. These were the auction coal, where the transportation takes place, movement of transportation takes place till now. It is there. So those people who allege, let them go to the concerned office and find out and check the challan we issued. See, that's what I'm saying. We issue challan. on the basis of the indicated quantity of coal. Whether it is 10,000, whether it is 20,000, whether it is 30,000. On the basis of that, after due process is completed, then DMR will issue. Mining Jawi Depan will issue the challan. And the challan, you cannot issue extra. Suppose now if it is 20,000 metric ton, they calculate because now the challan per truck, 12 metric ton. 12 metric ton per challan. So if it is 12 metric ton, you calculate how many challan is required if it is for 20,000 metric ton of coal. So accordingly, challan will be issued to those successful quotational. It may come one book, it may come two books, it may come maybe 500 piece or maybe 1,000 piece. Then accordingly, from the DMR, after they pay the royalty and everything, then we issue the challan. That is me, that is the system. That's what I'm saying. Allocation can be just, you know, you can't make it. I mean, anybody can make. But I'm telling you, if you really concerned about that illegality, please help us. You go and find out from the office when is the challan issue, and then what is the total number of challan you issued, and then how many challans has been transported. That now, see, right now I'm telling you, Supreme Court has allowed mining of coal, but when they allow, you have to meet this laid down criteria. The laid down criteria is now you need to get the mining plan, and ultimately government of India will issue mining lease. So for these procedures, Mining and Jelipad has already issued the SOP. The SOP, how to apply, how to get all the documents in order, everything was there. So I don't know how many of them applied, I don't know, because I'm not looking after this department, but that is the procedure. We have already issued the SOP, even the workshop has been organized, be it in Chaitiel, East Chaitiel, be it in the Southwest Khasiel, be it in Garwin, encouraging those coal miners to come forward and then bring this document, prepare the mining plan, and then government will help you out to make sure that government of India approve the mining lease. What inquiry I'm telling you, we issuing order almost every day, be it the deputy commissioner, be it SP, be it the director of my mineral resources. We do have this mechanism in place. We do have these concerned authorities in place. We have told them, we keep telling them, see, the allegation made tomorrow, maybe different allegation can be made. But as I said to you, it can be easily made. Allegation can be easily made. But the fact remains, suppose now the truck driver, he passed on from Ribhoy district. In the Ribhoy district, as I said to you, be it transport department, they are there in the check-in. We call it women. These women, they need to get the women, and then they are there in the weighbridge. DMR are there, police also they are there. Then the magistrate also from the district. I'm saying are there. That's what I'm saying. We already have a machinery in place. So inquiry for what? I really don't understand. That's okay. That's what I'm telling you. If any illegal transportation of coal happens, we seized. After seizing of coal, we seized the vehicle, and then we seized even if we found out some stocks, be it old stock, be it whatever stock, new stock or whatever, we seized. When we seize, then the provision of law applies. The provision of law means once you seize it, you have to hand over to the court. Okay, do you want to ask, like Alam said, that we need inquiry?
Yes.
That's the point I'm telling you. That's why, because machinery is already in place, the mechanism, the government is already in place, we keep seizing. Those illegal transportation, if it is there, even today, we seize it. Yes, that's what, if it is happening, we seize it. See, like, okay, you tell me about this, the thief. When theft happened, police has to arrest them, right? Is it not? You get a point? We seize it. That's why, ultimately, we have to auction those seized goods. So, if you say that no government is allowing illegal transportation, I said from day one, no, we don't. Why we don't? And then why should we constitute inquiry? Because as I said to you, the government, the district administration, the government agencies are already on the road. Whatever, if they found 2-3 trucks, they trying to carry illegally, seize it.